The anthem has unique features, easy to memorize, melodious with an all-inclusive message, the reason it has stood the test of time. Parliament today paid tribute to the fallen son of the country and asked government to pay for Kakuma's work without hassles in court.
Great man, the man that has left a legacy, the man that has left an asset for Uganda, the national anthem.
That this government recognizes Professor George Wilberforce Kakoma as a true patriot and national hero.
MPs have also asked that the anthem, which is unusually sung in full, was today translated into all local languages. Speaker after speaker praised Kakuma after the third Deputy Premier, Lieutenant General Moses Ali, moved the motion to pay tribute to Kakuma, seconded by Opposition Chief Whip Winfred Kiza and Conservative Party President John Kenil Chams.
That it takes cognizance of the distinguished services rendered and the contribution made by the late Professor George Wilberforce Kakuma, both at local and international levels.
Where Professor Wilberforce Kakuma was being told to us as the proposal of the Uganda National Anthem.
The casket, managed by pallbearers from the Uganda Funeral Services, arrived at Parliament at 8:31 a.m. and was received by the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, who later signed the condolence book. The body was later ushered into the chambers at 2 o'clock per fully packed house. Government is meeting all burial expenses for George Wilberforce Kakuma, who died on Sunday, April 8th, aged 89. He's a long-time educationist who kept the love of his trade up to the last breath. Kakuma will be buried at Mabombe in Makiso District on Saturday after a special funeral service in Namirembe Cathedral. Debate still rages on whether he should be buried in Kololo as a national hero. Moses Al Said Bega, Namayo Moses, Evelyn Namuaya, NBS Television.